HTML is a programming language, and if you want to rush to the comment section right now to tell me how wrong I am, you have not heard of the newest invention of Big Sky Software, the same company that made the highly controversial JavaScript framework HTMX. HTML, the programming language, is, well, a programming language that uses HTML, the markup language, as its syntax. The language is stack-based, which means in order to perform operations on data, we have to push it on a stack and reference it from there. It also claims to be turing-complete, which would basically mean it could solve any computational problem given enough time and memory. I probably learned how to prove that in university, but it was revealed to the authors of the language in a dream, which sounds like a legit source to me. What I can prove, however, is that we can build a calculator with it. While HTML, the programming language, might not be the most efficient one, it's definitely a fun one. It's the newest addition to an ever-growing collection of languages, including Whitespace, Shakespeare, and Brainfuck, called esoteric programming languages. HTML programs run inside a main tag. In order to write a hello world program, we push the string hello world to the stack using the s tag, and use the output tag to print the result. To actually execute the HTML program, we need to embed html.js, because HTML, the programming language, is implemented in JavaScript. But in order to program our calculator, we also need to capture user input. Luckily, HTML, the programming language, offers an easy and intuitive way to achieve that, using the input tag. Using it in HTML, the programming language, will prompt a pop-up to get the user input. This input will be automatically pushed to the top of our stack. To add up two values, we can just use two input tags, which will push the inputs to the top of the stack before using one DD tag, which performs an addition to the top two values of our stack and pushes back the result. HTML, the programming language, also supports conditional execution, better known as if statements, which we will use to make our calculator support subtraction, multiplication, and division. Based on the selected operation, we'll either use the DD tag for addition, the sub tag for subtraction, the UL tag for multiplication, or the div tag for division. To make life easier, HTML, the programming language, also supports variables, which can be used to store values from the stack and write back values to the stack at any point. If you ever get stuck, HDB, the HTML debugger, is here to help. It lets you step through the steps executed by HTML, the programming language, to help you understand exactly what's going on. Because if you encounter a bug, be aware that it's your fault, as HTML, the programming language, is correct by definition. The bug, therefore, is not in the programming language, but rather it is in you. But you are not limited to the tags that HTML, the programming language, provides. It can be easily extended by defining the functionality of a tag in JavaScript. If we want to add a blink tag, it's just a few lines of code, and after reloading, it works flawlessly. To improve our HTML calculator, we can use loops to allow chaining of unlimited operations until we receive an equation sign. Loops in HTML programs can be achieved by the anchor tag, in combination with an ID set on another HTML element. It works like a go-to and continues to execute the program from the reference element forward. What's still missing in our calculator is that we actually output the result of our calculation. By default, HTML, the programming language, will output the top entry of our stack to the JavaScript console when using the output tag. But this can be customized as well. In our case, we will write the value to an HTML markup element outside of our HTML program. The calculator works flawless now, and if you find any bugs, the bugs are not in my code, but rather inside of you, because my HTML calculator is perfect by definition. If you want to check out the HTML code for the calculator, you can find the link to the GitHub repository in the description down below. And while you're down there, consider leaving a like if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe if you want to be clickbaited into more videos like this. See you in the next one.